also to the men's singles final on the number one seed, Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia against Kenichi Tago, the number six seed from Japan. But look at the quarterfinal stage, which in fact was the third round. Five Indians present in quarterfinals of the men's singles. That has never happened previously at any Super Series event. An absolute first. And what a delight to see once again in the semi-final stage, four different nations represented. All but one of our disciplines, and that was women's doubles. Had four different countries represented.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to stage. The men's match of the day, the men's singles final. Please welcome the technical officials for the men's singles final.
Popular wherever he plays around the world, and there's a huge number of Malaysian supporters in the crowd here today at Siri Sports Complex in Delhi.
Please welcome Kenichi Tago of Japan. Put your hands together.
So his opponent, the number six seed, Kenichi Tago of Japan, appearing in his fourth Super Series tournament final. He's lost his first three, and the first three he lost to a certain Lee Chong Wei on finals day. Finalist at All England in 2010, the French Open of 2011, and the Malaysian Open last year.
Come on, ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Lee Chong Wei of Malaysia. Welcome, Kenichi Tago of Japan. Please welcome the umpire for men's singles final, Ravana De Silva of Sri Lanka.
So as the officials get introduced, that statistic is really rather ominous if you're a Japanese man. 12 matches played, 12 wins to Lee Chong Wei. Last time they met was in the semi-final of that Hong Kong Open at the end of last year. Two straight games. In fact, of their 12 previous meetings, only twice has it gone to three games. The last time that Kenichi Tago took a game off Lee Chong Wei was in the quarterfinal of the Japan Open of 2011. So the number one seed, Lee Chong Wei, world ranking of one, of course, born in Georgetown in Penang, Malaysia, 30 years ago. He was winner here in 2011. He was beaten finalist last year. Surprise loss to Sung Wan Ho of Korea. This his fourth final of the year. He's already won two titles, the Korean Super Series, the Malaysian Super Series, lost in the final of the All England. So this the fourth Super Series of the year, and the fourth time that he's been in the Super Series final. The only tournament he's played this year where he's failed to reach the final was the Australian Grand Prix and lost in the semi-final. I think he has good reason not to take anything away from his opponent, who beat him, went on to win the title, Tian Haowei. But there was a small matter of his wife giving birth to their baby son. Happened a few days later, thankfully got home in time and was with her. So to Kenichi Tago, the 23-year-old from Saitama in the suburbs of Tokyo. Number 9 on the world ranking, number 6 seed here. Only making his second appearance here at the Indian Open 2 years ago. He lost in the last 16. So this is the best he's ever done at this particular tournament. But for Kenichi Tago, this is his first final for 15 months since he lost in the final of the 2012 Malaysian Super Series. Ana da Silva. Chong Wei, the world number one, appearing in his third consecutive Indian Open final. And it was tennis, of course, against the number 6 seed, Kenichi Tago. And of course, Kenichi Tago really shot prominence in world terms when he reached the final of the 2010 World Cup as an unseeded player. Passed out in the final to his opponent of today, as indeed he's done in all three previous Super Series tournament finals that he's been in. Having won all 12 of their previous meetings. That's a flying smash from Tago. Just trying to play safe against Lee Chong Wei. You've got to go for winners like that. Attack, looking to take initiative. It's just wide. Oh.
We request all the spectators not to use flash in their cameras. We repeat, we request you all to please switch on the flash, do not use the flash in your cameras. Thank you.
Net shot from Kenichi Tago earlier on in that rally, and he knows he had a missed opportunity. Had a short lift, smashed directly at a Lee Chong Wei who was equal to it. Series. This is 45th Super Series tournament final. They already won 30 of them.
Thank you.
obviously been working on his attacking game as Kenichi Tago. Because to me, he looks far, far more aggressive in the rallies than he has done in the recent past. Perfect net shot. He's going to get severely punished by Lee Chong Wei. He's trying to make it so tight. Inevitably making one or two errors. Makes it look so easy, and does Lee Chong Wei. Controlled aggression. Works the rally first, gets his opponent out of position before he goes for his winner. Net shot earlier on turned the momentum of the rally. problems. Yeah, couldn't impart enough pace on the shuttle himself. 2 points away now from the second game. Lee Chong Wei. Slice used to great effect. Doubles players in the world, Ashiko Yonekiora. She was known for the quality of her defence, she would have been proud of that one. Tago isn't convinced by the call. There's been no overrule from the umpire. Kenichi Tago, certainly his all-out attacking style in those earlier stages were serving him well. I'm not sure that he's got the physical capabilities to keep that going. Chong Wei just soaking up the pressure. Coming from above the shuttle. That is just brilliantly taken. How quick is that? Tago. Very nice little lead. 9-point cushion. aspects of his game if he wants to go the whole way. At the mid-game interval, eight-point advantage. Interesting, Kenichi Tago out quickly after the mid-game interval, eager to get on with proceedings, obviously feeling confident, and why wouldn't you be when you've got an 8-point advantage? Now Tago doesn't like the call. Earlier on in that rally, to play a tight spinning net shot for Lee Chong Wei's tight spinning net shot. Judge got it absolutely right. That's some further away than Tago is. Oh no, that was in. Good call, line judge. Yep, on the line. Five straight points for the world number one. And all of a sudden, the advantage for the Japanese player doesn't look so healthy. shot from Lee Chong Wei. Just a little top spin put on the shuttle to guide it cross court. Look at this, that's extraordinary. But Tago equal to it, and how he controlled it to place it absolutely perfectly into that back corner. I don't know. Second game. Long. There are just signs that Lee Chong Wei is trying to force it a little too much, perhaps a little over anxious. Winning smash was straight down the line, tight time cross court. Well, I'll pose the question as to whether he may have left it a little too late in this second game, Lee Chong Wei. Thank you. just wide. Shot means that Kenichi Tago now has five game point opportunities to level this final at one game apiece. I thought that was going to go long. Oh, that is perfect. What a smash. Cool under pressure. Saved, another two remain for Tago. And this time he converts. 21-18, and it is one goal all in the men's singles final. Well, both players have taken the opportunity to change their shirts. Kenichi Tago seemed to remove the bit of strapping underneath his knee as he went to the 2-minute timeout. Now appears to be scrambling about in his racket bag to find some more tape put around that right knee. There we go. Strapping just came a little bit loose with the perspiration. I've got a little bit of patella tendonitis.
Final game, Lord
So here we go, third and deciding game. Just the start that Tago wanted. Two, Tago was taking him on at the net. Develop more weapons, more winning shots. Shows remarkable discipline. And Tago has managed to do it. Indecision, hesitation. His drop shot hit the top of the net, got deflected. Chong Wei just showing a bit of frailty in his confidence. Over anxious for these winners. That's what happens sometimes. it's coming thick and fast. Opportunities to use his attack. He's keeping the shuttle flat, keeping it going down, blocking to the net. That. And Tago just holding up proceedings because he wants the court mopped of the perspiration. Constructive rally from Lee Chong Wei. Making Tago twist and turn. After 51 minutes of play, just wonder if the sting has gone out of Tago's attack. It's Lee Chong Wei, as long as he holds his nerve. There's still lots of tactics going on. Advice from his coach. Chong Wei, the last few rallies, has appeared to be in command once again. So 11-8. was the one that did the damage and whipped backhand across court. Tago will need to be very careful here. 5 points the advantage to Lee Chong Wei. And Lee Chong Wei is a tremendous front runner. About him. A little bit of sting has gone out from his attacking play. Not quite the same elevation on his jump there. Hence the error. Not the reason the sting has gone out of his play is because of the amount of work that he's been made to do within the rows by Lee Chong Wei. Singles final as the court is mopped of the perspiration. Both the players take on board some liquid. Forward to hit flat to Chong Wei's forehand side. There's belief back in Tago. I can't remember the last time I saw Lee Chong Wei left stranded. Chong Wei's stopped attacking. It's looking very tentative. Giving the attacking advantage to his opponent. Just 1 point the deficit now. With his attacking play in the last four rallies, he's been strangely tentative. As soon as he got the opportunity, he hit the big smash again. He wins the point. Effort by both there on the defence and on the attacking play. Big effort to try and take the shuttle early from Tago. Desperation defence by the Malaysian. Missed opportunity. And now four match points. The world number one, Lee Chong Wei. Chong Wei wins his second Yonex-Sunrise Indian Open title, contesting his third consecutive final here in Delhi. Adds the 2013 title to the one he won 2 years ago. It is incredibly his 31st Super Series title, his third of 2013. His 47th career title in total. And of course, the first title as a father. Lee Chong Wei was under pressure. And let's spare a thought for Kenichi Tago, because he has improved and pushed the world number one the full distance. 1 hour and 2 minutes for his 21:15, 18:21, 21:17 victory. And for Lee Chong Wei, yet another Super Series title. So Lee Chong Wei,
ladies and gentlemen,
30-year-old from Malaysia, very relieved to be back on the winning trail again. What a battle he had in the final, thanks to Kenichi Tago.
Please welcome the runner-up, Kenichi Tago of Japan!
Four Super Series tournament finals. Four times he's had to settle for second best,
and
because for a fourth time he's lost in a Super Series tournament final to Lee Chong Wei.
Lee Chong Wei 31st
Super Series title for Lee Chong Wei. 31st, but I doubt it will be the last. Yet another title for Lee Chong Wei. Oh my goodness, he had to work hard for that.
To the runner-up, Kenichi Tago, Japan.
So the two men singles finalists take leave from the podium, and with Lee Chong Wei from Malaysia winning the men's singles title, it means that all five titles will definitely go to five different nations. Whether it's China or whether it's Korea who win the men's doubles, we know that the mixed doubles was won by Indonesia, women's doubles by Japan, women's singles by Thailand, Malaysia taking the men's singles, which means that all five titles will go to five different countries. So there we can see how the two pairs progress through to today's final here in the men's doubles. Number eight seeds from China, Liu Xiaolong and Chu Xian. Of course, it was their victory against the number one seeds, Matthias Boll and Carsten Mogensen, in the quarter final that really was the big story of that day. As far as the bottom half of the draw is concerned, well, the bottom half, the semi-final, was in fact an all-Korean affair, not Korean-Malaysia, with